Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to look at what makes a good leaving group. So a leaving group can either be an atom or a group of atoms that leaves over the course of a reaction and is replaced by another atom or group of atoms or a bond, perhaps. Now the leaving group can leave either at the same time that the new atom or group is coming in or the bond is forming, or in a separate step, and that has to do with the reaction mechanism. But we're going to take a look at what makes a good leaving group, what trends can we look to, so that you can apply those across a number of systems that you may encounter. The first trend we'll look at is the polarization of the carbon leaving group bond. So if you have a more electronegative or electron withdrawing group, you're going to end up with a pretty polar bond, and that is going to make it so that you have a good leaving group with a high affinity for electrons because it is electronegative, and then also you have a pretty electrophilic carbon because you're getting a pretty substantial partial positive charge on the electrophilic carbon there. So then the nucleophile could come in and attack. It would be really attracted to that electrophilic carbon because of the polarization of that bond. The second factor to consider is how stable is the leaving group once it's left. So X can either leave because it's kicked off, or it can leave by itself, depending on the mechanism. But ultimately, you're going to end up with X minus there. And the question is X minus stable? Because if it's not stable, it's going to go in the reverse direction, and then your reaction won't proceed. You'll go back towards the reactants. So one factor that can contribute to stability is size. The larger an atom is, the more surface area it has to spread out a charge, and so the more stable it's going to be. So the bigger the atomic surface area is, the more stable that charge is going to be. So large anions like chloride, bromide, iodide, those are all stable because they're large atoms with a lot of surface area to spread that charge out over. Another common leaving group is one that is protonated and positively charged, so that would become neutral upon leaving. So the water molecule is a common leaving group, or ammonia is a common leaving group, because upon leaving here, I just get neutral water and my electrophile, which would then react with something else. For this one, you get ammonia. So another common leaving group is when you protonate the leaving group so that it then becomes neutral upon leaving. Other common good leaving groups are those that are resonance stabilized. So whenever the charge can be shared over more than one atom, that is going to increase the stability of that molecule. And so we can see this oxygen can share electron density throughout that pi system so that the charge is spread out over two oxygen atoms as opposed to localized on one. Another common good leaving group that has resonance stabilization is OTS. So if you're not familiar with OTS, I have another video on what exactly it is, why you would use it, and how you convert to a leaving group of OTS. So here's the O part. And then the TS is this whole part here. And this is just another resonance stabilized molecule. The negative charge on the oxygen can be shared between these other two oxygens as well, so it makes it a very stable molecule upon leaving. And the last factor we'll look at that goes into what makes a good leaving group is one that stabilizes the transition state. So remember, the transition state is the structure that's in between when a bond is formed or broken. So it's not a reactant or a product or an intermediate that we can isolate. It's as the bonds are forming and breaking. So a leaving group that can help stabilize that by minimizing charge is going to make for a better leaving group and more of a reactive species. So the larger X is, the more polarizable it is. And so essentially it just keeps a bond or a partial bond to the carbon atom that it's leaving from for longer, lowering the energy of the transition state. So if we think about, you know, our X group, say it's just a halogen, it's spherically shaped, but because that carbon is developing a partial positive charge, it can become polarized so that there's more electron density on the side close to the carbon, and it sort of maintains a partial bond for longer, so there's less of a partial positive on the carbon, and it's less destabilized as the transition state continues. So this would be my carbon with my positive charge here, my partial positive. And the X is just kind of electron density is going to the left towards that carbon to help stabilize it. And the larger an atom is, the more polarizable it is and the more that is possible. So this has been a look at what goes into making a good leaving group in organic chemistry. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends.